Anemia is a common complication of chronic kidney disease, occurring in over 90% of patients receiving renal replacement therapy. The kidneys produce erythropoietin, a hormone essential for red blood cell production. When kidney function declines, erythropoietin levels drop, causing anemia. In February 2023, the United States Food and Drug Administration approved Daprodustat, under the brand name Gestivroc, to treat anemia in patients with chronic kidney disease who are on dialysis. This was the first oral treatment for the disorder. Daprodustat works by targeting hypoxia-inducible factor, or HIF pathway. HIF is a crucial regulator of red blood cell production, sensitive to oxygen level changes. At normal oxygen levels, prolyl hydroxylase domain, or PHD enzymes, constantly break down HIF. When oxygen levels drop, the degradation process slows down, allowing HIF to accumulate. HIF subunits, alpha and beta, combine to form a functional HIF dimer. The HIF dimer moves into the nucleus of the cell and binds to specific DNA sequences called hypoxia response elements. This activates the transcription of numerous genes that stimulate erythropoietin production and increase iron metabolism and utilization. These processes increase red blood cell production. This HIF pathway can be pharmacologically activated. Daprodustat inhibits PHD enzymes, allowing HIF to build up, subsequently increasing erythropoietin production and iron utilization. Through this mechanism, daprodustat increases red blood cell production. The FDA approved daprodustat based on the positive outcomes from the ASCEND trial. This global Phase 3 clinical study involved almost 3,000 patients with dialysis-dependent chronic kidney disease with anemia. Patients were randomly assigned to receive either daprodustat or an injected erythropoietin-stimulating agent, darbepoetin alpha, a standard care treatment. The graph shows the mean hemoglobin levels among patients during the trial. Hemoglobin is the oxygen-carrying component of red blood cell and a common measure of anemia. Daprodustat improved and maintained hemoglobin within the target levels of 10 to 11 grams per deciliter, similar to standard care erythropoietin-stimulating agent. The most common adverse effects of daprodustat were high blood pressure, blood clotting events, including heart attack, strokes, and blood clots in lungs and legs, and abdominal pain. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.